Bruriah is the result of one woman's determination. Until 1963, very few of our girls went beyond eighth grade in education. Those whose parents wanted them to have that education sent them to New York, to Brooklyn, or to Manhattan. By 1963, it was beginning to be less of an option than it was before. And there was one parent of an eighth grade girl, her name was Rose Pinchas, who was determined that there be a high school for girls in town. At that time, we were in the process of building the Masifta building, which was completed in 1965. And starting another project was the farthest thing from anyone's minds. But she was determined. Milton Levy, Olav HaShalom, without asking anyone, made a deposit on a beautiful home at 35 North Avenue. So it was there, the building was there. As long as the building was there and it housed the fourth, fifth, and sixth grades during the construction period, there was enough room to have another classroom for Bruriah, for a girls' high school, which was begun with 10 ninth graders. The deposit that was made on the building was a very little one, and the rest of the building had to be paid for. Leonard Diener, Olav HaShalom, came to the rescue. Bruriah was chosen as the name because Bruriah, Reb Meir's wife, symbolizes scholarship in Jewish women. One problem was that there was no pool of women administrators. There was only one that we knew of who was a principal in an elementary school. And when we asked her if she could recommend anyone, she said, sure, my sister. Her sister was named Chaya Newman. And the rest was history.
I always tell people I have four brothers, but I had hundreds of sisters because Bruriah was a member of the family. Mrs. Newman, Alei HaShalom, my mother, treated Bruriah like one of her children. She nurtured it, cared for it, and took a tremendous amount of pride and pleasure as it grew and as it flourished. She understood children, she understood girls, and she understood parents, and she did her best to make the educational system here at Bruriah work for everybody involved. It was a place where students felt safe, where they felt they could grow. And she used to tell parents, you don't have to be an A student to come to Bruriah. You just need to want to grow.
One of the days that really I'll never forget was the day that the young Mrs. Tights came in as our teacher. And she was somebody that was like this tremendous breath of fresh air. She just walked in with her back held straight, and next thing we know, she's sitting on the desk propped up and giving us this shiur. We had never seen anything, had any type of a teacher like that beforehand, and it was amazing.
Mrs. Newman was really my role model. She was an incredible human being, dynamic, loads of energy. It's an understatement. It was constant, consistent, persistent.
The girls are not going to care how much they know until they know how much we care.
And she saw something was a little askew because here I was, a bright young lady, if I say so myself, but failing in every class. She saw that there was something wrong. So she didn't want me to be a loser. So she made me the program coordinator of all the extracurricular activities. So every morning I woke up and I was a winner because I went to school and I had an important job. I felt like a somebody. And just looking back, I'm so grateful. Until this day, I consider her my role model.
To Mrs. Newman, her joys were so tied up and wrapped up with her students' joys. You could see the shine on her face when somebody was able to achieve a milestone, when they celebrated a wedding. Even if it was difficult and distant, she would love to be there, and so filled with her life zest and joy for them. That was always apparent. Their personal needs became her needs, and she would look for every avenue to take care of them.
We really feel like we're a family. We just share each other's lives. I sit there sometimes in a chef's office and I say, what would I do if I had a school with girls whom I didn't care for? And that just doesn't happen, hasn't happened in 32 years.
We have to be responsible people and worry about the children and worry about how they're going to grow up and make sure that there are good caliber people out there educating them and being role model.
How many times did we hear Mrs. Newman's mantra of they won't care much they know until they know how much we care? And what's amazing is that I never realized that it worked on me as well as on her students. Now that I have to fill Mrs. Newman's shoes in an impossible task, I realized that I learned so much more from her than I ever thought I had learned. It's clear as day that I learned what she taught because I knew how much she cared about me and about Bruriah. And I can only pray that I make her proud as she watches from above.
It is just a wonderful, wonderful life. I feel Hashem has blessed me so much that I can't thank him enough. And I can't imagine any other career where you could say that at the end of your life.
Schools all over the world look to the Bruriah model, the workbooks that we produce, the curriculum that we have, and in large part that was due to Mrs. Newman's guiding force, her vision. She had this idea of what she wanted Bruriah to be, and by the sheer will of her determination, she made it what it is.
She had this paradigm in her head of what she wanted for the girls, what she wanted for the school. And we just went along for the ride.
And I can say that, yes, we've done an incredible job in educating the girls in terms of the information that we give them, in terms of the skills that they learn, in terms of all the extracurricular programs that we run. But at the end of the day, the bottom line is that our girls know that we care about them immensely. And because of that, that completely opens them up to actually hearing what it is that we want to tell them.
Bruriah High School is a place where every student is cared about for themselves. In the classroom, on the basketball court, on the softball field, in charge of a committee, part of a committee, involved in something, involved in an activity, involved in their class, involved in the school. We make sure that each of the students have relationships with the teachers, where you can sit and you can schmooze and you can talk and you can really develop a relationship and learn from your teacher both inside and outside of the classroom.
I have a lot of fond memories of Bruriah. One of the fondest is our spontaneous Ruach Riots, where we would, without texting or cell phones or calling each other, just spontaneously mobilize in the hallways and break out into song and dance for about 15 minutes or so and block the hallways and the doorways so the teachers couldn't even get into the classrooms. I don't recommend it to the girls today.
It's hard to believe that it's 25 years since I first started teaching in Bruriah, but what's so amazing is that despite all the changes that have taken place in students, in education, and in the faculty over the last 25 years, Bruriah has always been a school that was open to and welcomed innovation. So that as our student population changed, because New Jersey grew and the number of Jewish communities in the area increased, we were ready. And when the needs of the educational system changed, when computers had to be integrated, as the sciences became important, when our students joined academic teams, not just sport teams, we were ready. The faculty here always knows that whenever we run a program, we're going to get together after that program and find out how we can do it better next time. Never the same. How we can do it better, because in Bruriah we're always primed to do things better, we're always ready to change, and we're always eager to embrace the needs of our students, and therefore the dynamic that is the only way to describe a school situation.
We are blessed with an incredible faculty. Besides being experts in their field, they take the time, both in class and out of class, to connect with their students, to develop a kesher with their students, to the point where our parents, when their students become parents, they send their girls back to Bruriah because they want them to experience that same education that they had when they were in school. People often ask me, is there such a thing as a typical Bruriah girl? By the time they leave the school, what are we looking to accomplish? And the truth is that there's no typical Bruriah girl, because everyone is coming from a different walk of life, perhaps from a different hashkafa, certainly from many different communities. And they're going to end up in a lot of different places, both professionally and personally. And if there was one thing that I would say was typical of a Bruriah girl, is that they've learned and embodied the lesson that we teach here, which is you always need to be growing, you always need to be improving, moving forward, then yes, that would be perhaps the typical Bruriah girl.